To be absolutely honest with you, we are utterly blown away by the love that this film's received. As independent filmmakers, it's, you know, such a responsibility to make, to be given a platform like this as well, to be able to do a film with such an incredible cast, an incredible crew. It's just an honour to have it recognised at BIFFA, and I know I speak for every single member of that cast and crew in that we are just delighted to be here, delighted to be a part of it.
Well, we did a short film of it, which was nominated for a BIFFA 2 years ago. So it was just a continuation of that story, really. It was always a plan to do a feature version of it. And Phil and I did Villain in between the short and the feature, and then moved on to this, really. It was always part of the plan, as it were. But I know it was very close to Phil's heart, something in the service industry, drawing on his own experiences and stuff. And yeah, that was the reason, basically.
Can you talk particularly, I guess, about Stephen's performance and what makes him such an exemplary attraction for this film?
Well, that was the one good thing. Once Stephen was on board, everyone wanted to work with Stephen. He really is a firecracker. And actually, we didn't quite know every single time how he was going to be in the moment. And that's the amazing thing about Stephen. He literally acts absolutely in the moment. And that's something that's so unique about him. He brings such truth to the role. And I mean, I could not have asked for somebody better to play that role. I mean, he's a phenomenal actor. And I really hope that this catapults him into doing even more amazing work, basically.
I mean, it's an incredible honour, and we just feel really happy that people have responded to the film in the way that they have, and to be in such incredible company. You know, independent film has had a really tough time over the last couple of years, so to be able to come together and to celebrate and to be with other filmmakers is really exciting and just something we've all missed. It was the process. And the script, like, it's based on our director Phil's experiences, things he's witnessed and experienced himself. And I just think it's full of vulnerability and heart. And then you get the process on top of that of doing a one-shot film and improvising the dialogue is what really excited me. And to work with incredible people like Stephen, who brought me on board, it's not often you get to do a project like that. It's really special.
Can you talk a little bit about how you went about achieving that unique feat of doing a film in one shot? Because it's rarely attempted and even more rarely succeeded in.
No, I know. I would say I do think it's not just, it hasn't been done just for a trick. I think it really serves the story. So it really serves the pressure of that situation and of those characters in that moment in time. We rehearsed, not for very long, but we had the front of house team had 5 days, we had 5 days as kitchen staff, and we just workshopped. But again, I think that's why it's a special film, because the team of people that came together was really special.
When it comes to Stephen Graham, there's an endless list of adjectives, superlative to describe him. Can you quantify, though, what makes him such a very unique, such a very special performer?
He's just real. I'd say that. So he's just real. He's a very generous, no airs and graces. Matt, I think that comes through in his performances. They're true. They're real. You know, there's nothing superfluous to them. I could give you one of my favorite moments in the film, if that's different, which is with the pastry chefs in the kitchen. I think that's such a really beautiful moment and play with such economy and truth that it punches you in the gut, I think, that moment.
I'm curious, as a storyteller, if you yourself have an answer to that question about why stories are so important in our lives.
I just think they're fundamental to humanity, really. It's how we make sense of the world, is to tell stories. And I think they're essential. I think it's part of us. It's not merely entertainment. We need to have stories to process life, the complications and the madness of life.
Of course, we're here tonight specifically celebrating independent cinema. What do you think that form of storytelling gives us that we perhaps don't get from other types of mass entertainment?
Well, I just think there's a wider range of voices. You know, it's not based so much on commercial success. So you're always going to get a wider range of viewpoints. I think that's really important. Everybody deserves to be reflected on screen. So as many experiences as we can bring to screen, the better.
Do you have anything else that we should be looking forward to? Anything else that you're going off to do this year or next?
Oh, what, in my own personal work? Well, I'm working on another job with Stephen at the moment, which is Code 404, which is really fun because it's completely different. Comedy, very light, so the opposite to Boiling Point.
Hi, my name's Lauren Ajufo.
Tell us a little bit about where you fit into Boiling Point and what makes it such an explosive and exciting film.
Well, the improvisation of it, the fact that you get to delve into different characters, especially with mine, Andrea, she's your typical teen, but her story is very, very important in everyday life, I believe, and I think that adds a lot into the story.
You talk about working with Stephen and what makes him such a unique talent.
Stephen, he literally became my dad. He's absolutely amazing. It was an honour. His inspiration, his dedication, he's just so, so passionate about his job and his work, which I think is really important and which added to the film a lot.
And what do you think this film has to say, both about the service industry that it explores and perhaps the wider human experience?
I think it opens up a lot to what isn't seen a lot. Like myself, I didn't know that many chefs suffer from addiction, and I think that's very important to show. And that as customers and as people, we need to be patient and just stay calm, and it just introduces you to a different life we didn't see.
And was it a particular challenge filming the film in the way it was with the one-shot approach?
100%. We're all used to takes, but this one was just go for it, which I think it added a lot because everyone's reaction was always true and real, which added to it, really.
And it looks great on screen, but I'm curious, did anything go wrong? Were there any particular moments where improvisation was necessary?
Yeah, when like different things were put in place, like Stephen would say there was a bin that was in the way, he had to move that, but he added it into the script. And because the whole thing was improvised, anything that wasn't in its place just added to it, really.